I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm talking about the top 7 most harmful foods for your skin that people keep eating. Your skin, your glow, wrinkles, facial sag, they absolutely depend on what you eat and also when you eat. Number 7 is sugary drinks. I'm talking sodas, soda pop, originally marketed as a health tonic, if you can believe that, and sold in pharmacies in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. Soda pop was often advertised as a cure for various health problems, including headaches, indigestion, and even impotence.
Check this historical ad out. The ideal brain tonic relieves fatigue for discriminating people. Now check this one out. Headache? Question mark. Head right? Exclamation. Stomach right? All's right. The best brain and nerve drink. Can you imagine? But this was what was promoted at the time.
In fact, Coca-Cola's original formula, yes, it did contain cocaine. A lot of people wonder about that. Is it a myth? It's true.
I feel the need for speed.
It was believed to have medicinal properties at that time. However, we now know energy drinks, yes, sport drinks as well.
How many of you are drinking this? Me too. I drink one whole bottle after I play hockey. Did you know there's 3 tablespoons of sugar in this drink? But we're all drinking it.
They're loaded with sugar and calories, which can lead to obesity, type 2 diabetes, and other health problems. Instead of sugary drinks, try switching to water, unsweetened tea, or low calorie drinks. A little bit of soda water with a twist of lime or lemon is great. Number 6, processed meats. They were originally developed as a way to preserve the meat before we had refrigerators. Meats like bacon, sausage, and ham, they were salted and cured or smoked, and that prevented them from spoiling and extended their shelf life. However, with the invention of the modern refrigerator, these preservation methods became less necessary, and the popularity of processed meats grew more for taste, and this one kills me, convenience. Yes, people take them for convenience. Often convenience is unhealthy. Hot dogs, bacon, deli meats, they're high in sodium and preservatives, which can increase your risk of heart disease and cancer, 2 top killers in the world. Instead, try meats like chicken or fish or plant-based options. The key here is eat real food. Number 5, white bread. Now, white bread used to be considered a luxury food item. Yes, in the 20th century, white bread was seen as a symbol of wealth and status, as the refining process removed bran and the germ from the wheat flour, and that was expensive and time consuming. However, as industrialization and mass production made the refining process cheaper and faster, white bread became more affordable and widely available. And when things are affordable and widely available, they're no longer considered a luxury item.
This happens with many of our foods. When we try and make them widely available, the quality goes down. Look at this. Lemon was a luxury item for ancient Romans, the study finds. In fact, I'm sitting in Japan right now, and look at this. Food and drink, including fruit, are frequently given as an offering at shrines and temples. I've seen this and I've asked, and it's because of the scarcity. So you get real fruits here. So it's a great gift. It's an offering. However, when you try and make it available to everyone, what happens? Go buy a strawberry or a blueberry at your local grocer. You're not even going to taste anything. It's not going to taste like what you think a strawberry should. That's because we're making them available, and we're making them with very poor quality in greenhouses with no nutrition. And the same thing happened to bread at the time.
So it actually became a staple of many households. Refined grains like white bread, pasta, and rice have been stripped of their nutrients, leaving you with empty calories. Instead, opt for whole grain bread, other whole grain products, and you want more fiber and nutrients. If you're eating, you may as well eat healthy. Number 4, fast food. It has become so popular that there are now, can you believe it, fast food themed weddings.
Check this one out from a couple of years ago. Couple named Burger and King get married in a fast food themed ceremony. It's a match made in fast food heaven. Funny one, but real.
Some couples, yes, have chosen to tie the knot in fast food restaurants with menus featuring items like hamburgers, chicken nuggets, and fries. While this may seem unconventional, it's a testament to the ubiquitous nature of fast food in our society. Fast food, unfortunately, is often high in calories, unhealthy fats, and sodium. This can lead to weight gain, high blood pressure, and other health issues, including insulin resistance, often unthought of but important. Instead, try cooking at home more often using healthy, real ingredients. It saves money too. Number three is artificial sweeteners. They were discovered actually by accident. In 1879, a chemist named Constantine Fahlberg was working on coal tar derivatives in his lab.
Yes, you heard me exactly right. It came while we were inventing coal tar products.
He accidentally forgot to wash his hands before eating dinner. What he noticed was that the bread he was eating tasted sweet, and after investigating, he realized that the compound he had been working with, saccharin, was the source of the sweetness. This accidental discovery led to the creation of the first artificial sweetener and opened the door for the development of other sweeteners like, you'll recognize, aspartame and sucralose. Artificial sweeteners like aspartame and sucralose have been linked, unfortunately, to many health problems, headaches, digestive issues, and unfortunately, cancer. Instead, try using natural sweeteners like honey or maple syrup in moderation, of course. Honey, of course, is an antibacterial, so some natural sweeteners have a lot of other factors that you might enjoy. Number two, potato chips. Now, I love potato chips, so this one hurts me.
In Canada, we have something called ketchup chips. They're highly addictive. Have you tried them?
They were invented by a chef who was trying to get back at a customer. In 1853, a customer at Moon's Lake House Restaurant in New York complained that his French fries were too thick and too soggy. Chef George Crumb, who is known for his thin, crispy fried potatoes, decided to slice the potatoes as thinly as possible and fry them until they were crispy to teach the customer a lesson. However, to his surprise, the customer loved the new creation and the potato chip was born. Just like in aesthetics, a lot of the products we use are found by accident. Potato chips are loaded with unhealthy fats and sodium, which can increase your risk of heart disease and other health issues. Instead, try snacking on fruits, vegetables, or nuts. They're healthier alternatives. Now, number one is everywhere, and you'll know it in high fructose corn syrup. High fructose corn syrup was invented as a cheaper alternative to sugar. You see, in the early 20th century, sugar prices began to rise, and corn farmers in the U.S. were looking for ways to use their surplus crops, their leftovers, for something that would create money. So in the 1950s, researchers developed a way to convert cornstarch into glucose syrup, which could further then be processed into high fructose corn syrup. This new sweetener was cheaper and easier. You see the common theme? Cheaper and easier we tend to gravitate towards than producing sugar. And it became quickly popular as an ingredient in many processed foods and beverages to lower the cost. Today, high fructose corn syrup is still used as a sweetener in many products, although it's become controversial. Found in so many of our processed foods, has indeed been linked to obesity, type 2 diabetes, and many other health products. You want to reduce your consumption of this and go for more natural foods and flavors. If you've liked this video, click this one to watch how you can boost your elastin and collagen through your diet. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.